station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine McLaurin. This week, our crew members wrapped up a spacewalk and are now getting ready for a new delivery of science and research. Expedition 55 flight engineers Drew Feustel and Ricky Arnold completed the 209th spacewalk in support of space station assembly, maintenance, and upgrades. This was the 7th spacewalk for Feustel and the 3rd for Arnold. During the spacewalk, they installed wireless communication equipment on the Tranquility module to enhance data processing for the eco-stress experiment that will be arriving on a future cargo ship. This experiment will measure the temperature of plants on Earth to better understand how much water plants need and how the plants respond to stress. The crew members also replaced the pan-tilt mechanism for a camera on the outside of the station and removed aging hoses from the cooling component on the station's truss. Now that the spacewalk is completed, station residents are getting ready for next week's special delivery from SpaceX. On Monday, April 2nd, SpaceX will launch its 14th cargo resupply mission to the ISS. The SpaceX Dragon is packed with almost 5,800 pounds of research, crew supplies, and hardware. Research highlights include a study on metabolic tracking that will evaluate the metabolic impacts of pharmaceutical drugs, the Atmosphere-Space Interactions Monitor that will study severe thunderstorms and their role in the Earth's atmosphere and the climate, and the Veggie Passive Orbital Nutrient Delivery System experiment that continues NASA's plant research by testing a new way to deliver nutrients to plants. The Dragon will spend almost a month attached to the space station before returning in May with results of completed experiments. Live coverage will begin at 4 p.m. Eastern on Monday, April 2nd on NASA TV and at nasa.gov/NASA Live. Manish on Twitter wants to know why it takes so long for the ISS to open the hatches once the Soyuz is docked to the station. After docking, the crew conducts a series of leak checks, checking in with flight controllers back on Earth, and making sure that there is a perfect seal between the Soyuz and the hatch on the space station. The process takes about 2 hours to complete. During this time, the crew can get out of their launch and entry suits and get ready to move inside station. Keep sending us in questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.